Hello everyone. In this video, I'm gonna talk about the Shi asymmetric epoxidation. The Shi asymmetric epoxidation allows the synthesis of epoxides from alkenes using a fructose-derived organocatalyst with Oxone. This ketone can be synthesized in two steps from the very cheap chiral starting material, D-fructose, by catalyzation and oxidation of the remaining alcohol with pyridinium chlorochromate. In this catalyst, the stereocenters are close to the reacting center, so the stereochemical communication between the substrate and the catalyst is efficient. Also, the presence of fused rings or quaternary centers alpha to the carbonyl group minimizes the primarization of the stereogenic centers. Besides, its enantiomer can as well be prepared from L-fructose. The first step of the synthesis is the oxidation of the catalyst with Oxone to generate the active epoxidation reagent. To this end, Oxone adds to the ketone group on the catalyst. This nucleophilic addition leads to a sulfate intermediate, which is a good leaving group that facilitates the ring closure to the corresponding dioxirane intermediate. This dioxirane derivative induces then the asymmetric epoxidation of the alkene, while regenerating the ketone for the next catalytic cycle. The pH of the reaction medium has a crucial effect on the outcome of the reaction. At high pH, the oxidant, Oxone, decomposes rapidly, while at lower pH values, the catalyst is decomposed via Weyer-Villiger oxidation. Besides, the epoxide products are less stable at lower pH values. At the optimum pH value, approximately 10.5, the epoxidation usually takes place with high enantiomeric excess at low catalyst loadings. According to the suggested spirotransition state, oxidation by the active dioxirane catalyst takes place from the re phase, due to steric hindrance of the opposing C phase. For this reason, transdisubstituted and trisubstituted olefins give high enantioselectivities, whereas for cis-disubstituted and terminal olefins, the enantiomeric excesses are lower.